Frank Show, what? The Frank Show, come on, the Frank Show, what? The Frank Show, come on, the Frank Show, what? The Frank Show, come on, Frank Show. It's time for the show.
All right, so it's 2024. If the world had one of those little smiley face shots a doctor made to use as a child, I feel like we'd be leaning towards the right. Thankfully, modern engineers have brought us a marvel of technology that may just be one of the most phenomenal escapist and community-building tools in the history of mankind. The tech is finally here and is here to stay. I am sure we'll see a future where space devices become the main point of entry for creating long-lasting memories, playing the best games, embarking on the highest tier virtual excursions, and possibly even your most used office space.
Hi, I'm gonna be the driver.
Oh God. I'm out of here.
Yeah.
So, as the wise man Tim Leary once said, let's
turn on, tune in, drop out.
Today's video only assumes one thing. You have never owned a modern virtual reality headset, and I will cover multiple entry points, so enjoy. All right, let's get started with our first use case. You don't own any form of video game console, PC, or mobile gaming device. You heard a little chatter from some folks down at the local watering hole, and you currently logged into a library computer watching his videos. You munch on some Lay's and drink a blue Gatorade. You often dream of a better world where you're a truffle hunter with a prize-winning pig, but deep down you know, like your failed relationships, that will never pan out. Well, boy, do I have a treat for you. You can hunt truffles all day and do many other tasks ranging from marvelous to menial with the Oculus Quest 2. All you really need is Wi-Fi and a cell phone to set it up, and those are pretty much a must. So as long as you got that going for you, I can assure you that the time spent in the Quest will feel much better than staring at a wall or watching that show again for the 10th time. And you can always do that too if you'd really like. I assume this is probably just a dip my toes in the water kind of situation, so I'd suggest looking into the used marketplace. You can probably find something sub $200. I would try OfferUp, Facebook Marketplace, and Craigslist, just to name a few, but I would highly suggest investing in a new facial interface if you go that route. I have no affiliation with them, but in the past, VR Cover always did a great job of offering a solid product. Quest 2 offers a great all-in-one package as an entry point into VR, and tech is solid, but I would still request a demo before you walk away from the sale if you go used. Maybe also request that they fully reset the device if you haven't already, because a fresh setup is really the preferred method. Meta does a great job helping you understand everything about the device when you first turn it on, and if you do have any other questions, you can always just ask me here or look up a YouTube video on the subject. All right, on to the next use case. You don't own a PC, but you do own a PS5, and your furry friends have been getting you all curious about what's going on in VR chat, so you decided to skip study hall for a long lunch and hit your vape while watching this video on your phone. You've seen some funny TikTok videos of VR games, and Fortnite just doesn't do it for you all the time anymore. Well, like our previous case, I would probably still recommend grabbing a Quest 2, with a caveat that if money isn't an option, you would also enjoy time spent in Quest 3. You might be saying to yourself, well, Frank, what about the PSVR 2? And based on my assumptions stated previously, I think your time and money will be better spent in the Quest ecosystem. You can find meme games all day, and there are tons of free-to-play social apps with high play accounts and fun gameplay. Plus, Water Ride can still be bumpy if you're not sideloading, trying to mod this and that. It's a fairly breezy experience from setup to fun. If you haven't already, maybe try out a friend's, but I would suggest grabbing a new headset if you plan on playing all the time. I would also suggest grabbing an upgraded head strap. Stock band, just too flimsy for heavy use, but if you just want to watch Netflix on a giant screen, there you'll be fine. Alright, on to the next case. You still don't own a PC, you do own a PS5, but you're a little older than our last subject. You heard some boys talking about getting wasted and bar fighting in VR, which sounded like a good way to take out some of that aggression you have towards your brainless boss who spends more time on holidays and Macy's around Christmas. You have no patience for yelling children, and you just want something that works. You're watching this video while you should be doing something else, but that's okay, because at the end of the day, they don't pay you enough to deal with all the BS you have to deal with on a daily basis. Well, for you, sir, I highly suggest investing in a PSVR 2. You probably already use the ecosystem and store. It's pretty much plug and play. You can do most games seated as well as standing, so you don't need an absolutely giant play space. You are pretty much always guaranteed the highest quality version of the game, the only caveat being if you're someone with a high-end PC, and the library is giant, so there is already a lot of stuff for you to check out. You might be able to get one of these used, but since there is no real way to replace the facial interface, I would still highly suggest going new. It's great out of the box, works well with glasses, and after the initial setup, you really don't even need to use the TV anymore. So you can always play while the TV is being used by someone else, unless you had nobody else to use the TV, in which case, hey, you can always save on electricity. All right, time for the next one. You own a PC, you don't own a PS5, and you could be any age at this point. You saw some videos of people using the Apple Vision Pro and you thought, hey, that looks kinda cool. You might have been excited about the productivity aspects, you might have just thought it looked funny to walk around with them, but overall the concept of spatial computing intrigues you on some level, and you feel like it's time to jump on that choo-choo train. You're most likely watching this video while eating some form of pizza and drinking a carbonated beverage between elongated trips to the bathroom and refrigerator. You may also be looking for a reason to get more active as well, and with all that in mind, I would suggest checking out a Quest 3 or Quest 2 if the money is a bit tighter. You can always plug it into your PC and take full advantage of everything the headset has to offer. There are tons of fun games you can get up and moving, and with so much variety, it's bound to be one that sticks, and I can guarantee you have a lot more fun starting the exercise in VR where you're free to be yourself in the privacy of your home. The Quest 3 also offers full color pass-through, and I can't tell you how helpful that has been when we just move it around and existing within a space in VR. It's really easy to transition between a virtual and physical world, plus there are new mixed reality games popping up every day that take advantage of the headset's capabilities and allow you to augment your space with fun, interesting, and useful applications. Tech is solid, platform is heavily supported, and the quality is great. I do recommend grabbing a better head strap though. Alright, on to our final case. You own a PC, you own a PS5, and you're ready to take the leap into the next generation of entertainment. Word around the water cooler is that the tech actually works now, and you're probably dropping the deuce and watching this video, which is cool. Just make sure you wipe well. Here is where we enter a bit of a gray area. If you're really interested in apps that push your tech to new use cases, I say go to Quest 3 all the way, but if you're just looking for quality gaming experience without all the bells and whistles, I'd say go PSVR 2. Not to mention PlayStation did announce that they are investing PC support on PlayStation VR 2 coming in the near future, so for all you know, it could soon become the best of both worlds. We already know that Sony is invested in body tracking platforms, so there's a good chance that could work with PSVR 2 on PC out the box, but time will tell how far that really goes. If you can't wait and you need the latest and most innovative stuff in your life right away, then go Quest 3. Works great on PC, offers you all the bells and whistles, plus it also works as a great all-in-one device when not connected to your PC. And if your main goal is PvP action, you'll find a lot more players in the Quest ecosystem. There are some amazing games on PSVR 2 as well, and a lot of them also offer crossplay, but if that's one of your main goals, you'll find much more success across a wide variety of apps on the Quest. There are also a much wider variety of PC-specific headsets available, but in my opinion, you want to go somewhere that offers the most support, and given the current landscape, I highly recommend these two outlets. Alright, in our next video in this series, we'll go over some great apps to get you started, some useful tips, and helpful information in your beginner's guide to VR. Thanks for watching. I hope this helped you in some way, and as always, if you need any help or have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. I'm Frank, this is my channel, and oh yeah, freaking subscribe. I mean, come on, nah. Smooches.